All right, welcome back. We are a week into the new year, and many have already given up on New Year's resolutions, especially when it comes to eating healthier.
That's right. Our next guest is here to keep us on track to a healthy lifestyle, not only in the first month of the year, but throughout the year. Welcome to the show, nutrition expert Ximena Jimenez.
Guys, welcome. I'm so excited to be here because January is my favorite month. Everybody's very positive. They want the best resolutions to eat healthier and to stay in shape or get in shape. So I love this month.
Do you think that, would you say that a high percentage of people give up on this healthier lifestyle after the first, second week?
Yeah, unfortunately, only 8% of the population stick with the weight loss goal.
Wow.
8%?
Okay. 8%, that's nothing.
Okay, so are people putting too much pressure on themselves with this resolution to eat healthier, and like, what can they do differently?
Let me tell you something. They're making mistakes, and usually the same mistakes that they did the year before. One of them is that they don't have breakfast.
When you don't gotta break the fast.
You cracked the whip with your voice on that. I was like, okay, you got my attention now.
Nice, that's what I wanted. Because what happens is that when you're running on an empty stomach, usually in the morning, we're the most active. We're running, thinking, planning, and that's when we need the fuel.
Yes.
So you can easily start the day with having some oatmeal. Uh-huh. I have some oatmeal and I'm adding some, you know, fruits and cottage cheese.
So yeah, I'm seeing the oatmeal and the cottage cheese on oatmeal.
You know what? There's no rules.
If you There's no rules.
If you like it, you do it. And if you don't like it, you add some milk. Easy.
Okay.
Or yogurt. You can do yogurt too.
You can do yogurt or you can do just the regular milk.
The point is, you're saying get your calcium in there.
And also get your protein in there, because you know what happens when you eat high protein foods like milk, cheese, yogurt, cottage cheese? What it does is that it lowers the ghrelin, and ghrelin is the hormone that produces hunger.
Okay, so it satiates.
Exactly, and protein and fiber too, but protein is the one nutrient that it keeps you satisfied. When you're satisfied, you're able to fight those cravings.
And you're getting protein here too.
Exactly, I have some, you know, yogurt, or you can put some feta cheese, whatever you like the best. And you know what, it's a good idea, because one of the mistakes people do when they go on a diet is that they eat the same thing over and over and over.
Yeah. And they deprive themselves
too. They deprive themselves, and you know what, when you eat the same thing all the time, you're gonna be having more cravings because you're missing all the other wonderful foods. Mm-hmm. Oh my God, you look like you're having fun.
Oh, it's crunchy and good. I want one too.
Crunchy, it's very important.
So do you think that we should be reading labels on everything?
You know what, it's a good idea.
Right.
And stay away from things that have a lot of sugar, a lot of salt, fat.
So why is it so important to have a balanced diet? Kind of explain to some
people
out there. Of
course, when it comes to balance, how can I explain balance? You know, variety.
Right.
And also balance means that you have some carbohydrates, some protein, some fat. And when you're adding, for example, dairy foods, they have a nice combination. Milk, for instance, have a combination of carbohydrates, some protein, and some fat.
Right.
If you use the whole milk.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what else do you have
for us
here?
And let's take a look at this. This looks like a superpower breakfast.
Isn't it wonderful? If you have the time, make sure, remember, there's no rules. So you can have a lot of vegetables for breakfast. Who said that?
Yeah, why
vegetables?
Not?
Exactly. I went to Europe last year and they were giving me lots of vegetables for breakfast and I was the happiest person. Probably they knew that I was a dietitian.
Yeah.
But I was happy.
But this is like almost like a salad.
It's almost like a salad, exactly.
And now, would you put dressing on this as well?
Yes, and I have a fantastic dressing here made with Greek yogurt.
So you, like a blue cheese or like a ranch or something
exactly.
like that?
But instead it's gonna be with Greek yogurt.
So it's got a lot less fat.
Yes, and you can put some spices to make it even better.
Okay, now I see I'm eyeing that thing with the toast over there. It looks like bruschetta in a way, but it's not really.
Do you like how it looks?
Yeah.
Is that Melba toast?
It's Melba toast with some cottage cheese again.
Of course, you love cottage cheese,
I love cottage cheese too. You know what I love it? Because it has twice or more the amount of protein than most dairy.
So, it's more concentrated.
It's more concentrated.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So you don't believe in like eliminating entire food groups?
No.
Moderation.
No, moderation. Moderation.
Okay. Yeah, because everyone's saying like, stay away from bread, stay away from grains, stay away from corn. You know, it's like stay away.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And everybody, you know, at the beginning, everybody's willing to do that. Like, oh my God, okay, let's eliminate. But then 2-3 weeks later, you're like, oh my God, what happened to my grains? You know, remember, you know, the bottom line is that you want to add, you know, a lot of vegetables because they're crunchy.
Okay.
And they give you some satisfaction. They have fiber. But remember, protein and fiber are the two key nutrients.
So what I kind of hear you saying is it's like, you don't have to get rid of anything. just add more veggies and more protein.
Yes.
And you'll work you'll work it out. You'll eat less of the other starchy things.
Exactly. And get creative. Don't do the same thing over and over and over.
I like this.
I'm sure you're going to have it later.
Yes. This has yogurt in it.
It has
Greek yogurt.
Exactly. Because you don't have to use only regular milk. You can use yogurt and make it thicker.
Right.
People like two things and they're satisfying. It's crunchy
and
creamy.
Creamy.
As children, we love that and we continue to love that even later.
I agree. I'm into crunchy and creamy. Seriously.
Okay. I'm salty.
And salty. you use salt in moderation, of course.
Okay. So I'm like thinking that like that with the toast and the Melba toast and the cottage cheese, you can season it.
Of course. Let me tell you something. Spices, seasonings are the best thing that you can do in your diet. The easiest way to boost not only the flavor, but the nutrients.
Jimenez, thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate it.
These are great tips, and thank you for breakfast. I was feeling a little nauseous, and now I feel great.
We'll be back in just a minute, right here on Daily Flash.